Good evening. It's so good to see all of you joining us and
on what?
On
Lessons from 48th Lane. There we go. All right. Great to have you here tonight. So we got some great things planned, but always got to start with the theme song. It's Thursday night.
We're hoping that some of the classes will be watching us either on tomorrow or Monday or whenever. And
who's the shout out this week for?
Second grade.
Second grade. Second grade. They gave me some really nice cards, homemade cards.
They were
beautiful.
Sweet.
Words.
He let me read them too.
Yeah, they were very, very nice. Thank you for those. And so shout outs for you. And I hear maybe even rumor.
A rumor has it that maybe, just maybe, there might be a treat for the second graders.
Whoa.
Oh, that'll be exciting. We'll just have to wait and see if that all happens. All right. Well, anyway, we're glad that you could join us. We are doing our lessons with Cooking with Jesus. So we have a treat that we have made for today, and we'll share that later on. And I think we're getting ready for the skit. And so we're going to begin. So, and action. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Super Chef America, the show where we teach you how to be a super chef. Today on Super Chef America, we have a special treat for you. I really hope that we're finally gonna meet our super chef from Japan, Chef Morimoto. Oh, I hope so. I talked with him on the phone, I did, and he assured me that he'd be ready to show us how to make, get this everybody, this is gonna be good, squid ink oatmeal. I tell you everybody, I just can't. Wait!
Out of curiosity, when did you talk to him?
Why are you asking?
Well, because he just called.
Not plane trouble again.
Nope, no plane trouble.
Oh, good. All right.
Plane made it here just fine. But he overslept and missed it.
Oh my goodness, not again.
But don't worry, we have a replacement.
Larry the lunch guy?
No, not Larry.
I know. Harry the camp cook.
No. He's in the wilderness, remember?
Okay, then who is it?
It's me, Gary, the greasy spoon guy.
Seriously, you look just like Larry. Mm-hmm.
I look nothing like Larry. Although I admit there's a slight resemblance to Carrie, my other brother. Yeah.
All right, everybody, I should explain that a greasy spoons are slang for small restaurants and low-cost menus. So, Carrie?
Yes. Oh, no, that's Gary.
Oh, okay, all right.
Why'd you call me Carrie for? I'm Gary.
Okay, got it. Okay, so can you just tell us, like, what is the name of your restaurant?
I thought I told you. It's Gary's Greasy Spoon.
Well, I didn't know if you were kidding or not.
When are you going to learn that Larry's the only kidder in our family?
So go ahead and tell me about Gary's Greasy
Oh, it is a special place. Let me just tell you, a special place. You know, if I have to say so myself, just check out our motto. I came up with this. Mm-hmm. Sometimes they say I've breathed too much grease fumes, but yeah. I'm telling you, I've got a brain up here.
Alrighty, let's hear it.
Pretty catchy.
Okay, I'm ready.
All right. We bring the great to Greece. It's awesome, isn't it? Yeah.
Quite.
Uh-huh. Yeah. I was debating between that or come to care, Gary's. It's not just greasy, it's spoontacular.
Wow, that is just a bit...
Yeah, it is a little too long. Not as snappy as the other one, but, I thought it was too much. But anyway, we just try to stick to the basics in our options, you know?
You mean like the classics?
Yeah, the classics, Yeah, if we can't fry it, we don't offer it. That's pretty basic.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You'd be surprised how many different kinds of food you can throw into, some butter or some oil or my personal favorite, lard. I love saying lard.
Wow.
Yeah, lard.
I was just thinking here, it doesn't really sound like a place where you can get like your fruits and veggies.
Oh, contraire. Oh man, of course you can get fried zucchini and okra and green beans and broccoli and cauliflower and mushrooms and of course our incredible duo.
I know, let me guess.
Onion rings and french fries. Yep, that's it, man. That's number one on the menu.
Mm-hmm.
And fruit.
Yeah.
Oh man, we make some awesome, big old oily fritters. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
So we got fruit too. It's mighty good eating.
So I'm assuming that today you are going to be frying something for us.
Actually, no, I'm not going to be frying anything today. I want to show the kids and I want to show the adults who are watching that I'm not just a one-man show. I'm not just the dude at the deep fryer. You know what I mean?
Alrighty, well, you know what? This sounds promising.
In fact, I made for you tonight my favorite fish.
Not fried fish?
No, not fried fish.
Baked?
No, not baked.
Oh, I know. Sushi.
Well, it's not really cooked, but it's not really sushi.
Well, then, what is it?
Well, I call it golden crispy fishies.
Ooh, let me
show you.
I want to see them.
Yeah, I'm right over here. I've got a whole bunch of them right here. Look, just look at these beauties. Look at these beauties right here. Look at those. Oh, I love those. And then there's these. Are beautiful, mm-hmm. beautiful. Yeah, right there. Oh, yeah. Golden fishy crispies. Yeah.
I'm pretty sure those are Rice Krispie treats.
Oh, no. They are golden crispy fishies. And I'm telling you, they've got a story to tell.
And cut. Well, this afternoon, when I came home from work, I had to go ahead and make these wonderful Rice Krispie treats. And they are so good. I had to make them beforehand because they needed like an hour to cool so that we could go ahead and cut them.
So that we can just put these little fishy things in here.
Our little cookie cutters and put those right in there.
So how do you make these? How do you make yours? I can tell you mine, but how do you make yours?
Well, mine, it has all the ingredients that you would just love. With your greasy spoon.
Oh,
you would just love it.
Yeah.
It has lots of butter in it.
Oh,
that
butter.
You put in a
butter
pan.
Is beautiful. It's beautiful.
And you melt it up. In fact, you make almost like a kind of a brown butter.
A brown butter.
Yeah, doesn't that sound good?
Yeah. You're telling me I'm a chef, man.
You take two packages of marshmallows, but you take two cups out of there. So then you put in your marshmallows and you melt all that down. And it smells delicious.
Yeah.
After that gets all melted down, then you add some Rice Krispies cereal, a lot of it.
Yeah.
And then a little bit of vanilla, which is yummy.
Uh-huh.
And then you stir it all up and you get it to, you put that other two cups of marshmallows in it. And the marshmallows, those two cups, they don't really get melted. They kind of look ooey gooey in there.
Yeah.
See how they look?
Why don't you try one of these?
I am going to.
All right.
And that's all you do. And then you put them in a pan, and then you have to wait for an hour, and then they cool down, And then you can do your little cookie cutters and make your fish like we made.
You know what? Your recipe sounds eerily similar to mine, but there is a little secret ingredient in there. Do you taste it? Mm-hmm. I put a little lard in there.
Lard.
Ha! I love lard.
I'm going to tell you, these are really good.
I'm sure they are. All right.
They are so good. I might have another bite before we start anymore.
Okay.
Yum, yum.
So what else are we going to talk about? Because we got the golden, and we said it had a story. But before we get to a story, mm-hmm. I'm just going to give you a hint. Mm-hmm. It's going to be a story about fish.
Uh-huh.
And so I'm going to go see if that Jeff character can come back.
Good, because we need him.
Okay, good.
Mm. I usually do not make good Rice Krispie treats. Now, this recipe that I follow, these are really gooey, and they are so delicious. Oh, my goodness. I'm going to be on a sugar high tonight. All right, so we're going to get started today, and we're going to make a boat to set the scene for our story. So if you're in your classrooms, you can hit pause, or you can run real quick and get a piece of paper. Okay?
Oh, yeah. Where's
Pastor
my paper?
Pastor Jeff's going to do this with me.
All right. Piece of paper.
I gotta wipe my hands off because they're wet. So this is your piece of paper, 8.5 by 11. That's all you really need, and it can be white, so you can decorate it later on. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna get our paper so that it's kind of, has a lot of flexibility to it. So we're gonna fold it a couple times. So we're gonna take it like this, and we're gonna fold it down like this, so it looks like this. And then we're gonna fold it across like this. So it comes pretty flexible anyway.
It's quarters.
Is it? Okay.
That's in quarters.
Yeah. And I like it because it's all flexible and easily pliable. Mm-hmm. I like that word, pliable. All right. So anyway, the first thing you're going to do is you're going to fold your paper like this, just like this. All I did was fold it in half. Okay. There we go. Did you do it?
It's folded in half.
Okay. So because I had a crease down the middle, you know, mm-hmm. and you do too, we're going to take these and we're going to take these corners and we're going to bend them over like this so they go right over to that middle, just like that. Got it?
Okay. And that'll leave a little
loose. That'll leave a big rectangle, right? All the way across. And then, got that, everybody? I got my triangles down. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to fold up these flaps. So I'm going to turn it like this, first of all. And then I'm going to turn it over on the other side and fold the flap up like this. So now, even if you can't do any more of it, you know, it's kind of cool. We have kind of a sailor's hat or a captain's hat or a pirate's hat or whatever you want to do. All right, so we have that so far. You can open it up.
I'm Popeye the Sailor Man.
Well, we have to continue on.
Different.
All right, so you can put your thumbs in there so you have that opening right there.
Yeah.
All right, got it? And you're going to just open it up like this, and you're going to make it into a diamond shape.
Ooh.
Which is pretty cool.
And diamonds then, are a girl's best
And then if you have these flaps down here that are kind of folded up like that, you just kind of want to flatten them down. I learned that the hard way. So just flatten them down so that they...
Okay.
Yeah, you don't want them all scrunched up. So you have your diamond shape.
Okay.
And then what you're going to take is you're going to take that part right here and you're going to fold it up like this into a triangle and you're going to fold up the other side like that so it looks like this.
All right, I'm almost catching up to
you. Okay, you got it? Oh, you're doing so good.
I'm surprised.
I know.
I'm not an origamiist.
I am not either, but this is pretty easy. All right, so the next thing you're going to do is you put your fingers...
Hi, Bella, by the way.
Hi, Bella.
Okay.
We did this on Zoom one time. I don't know if you remember or not. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and take the ends and we're going to fold it in like this. Woohoo! See that? And then it's going to look like this.
It's a diamond again.
Yes, it's a diamond just like this. And then you got these little flappies right here.
Uh-huh.
And you open them up and you have yourself... a boat. So cool. And guess what? You know what I'm going to do? I am going to...
Can I call it the
Oh, good job, Kristen. And for you teachers who are watching with your kids on Friday or Monday, If you want me to stop by and show the kids how to build a boat, I would be happy to do it. Maybe you can come too. All right?
I've got to come up with a cool name.
Isn't that fun? Did you have so much fun?
The SSJPS.
Oh my goodness.
All right. All right. We made a boat.
Pretty cool.
And that, all right, so now we've got a boat.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so if we're going to talk about...
Is that all the story?
We got fish. No.
Boat and fish.
We got fish.
Hmm.
All right, so we got fish, different kinds of fish. And by the way, kids, we're not bringing you these because I've had my hands on them.
Yes.
And I wouldn't do that. If it was pre-COVID times, I probably would, but I'm not doing it now. All right, so anyway.
That's my boat.
So here we go.
All right,
so I got a boat now and I got fish.
Yeah.
And so what we need, let me think. Let's think about this. If we've got a boat and we got fish, what else do we need? Hmm. Anybody? All right, come on now. You can call it out. Exactly. We need fisher people, fishermen, fishers. We need fishers.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, you know what? For the story I have in mind, we need 12 of them. We have the big fish.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah.
That's Jesus, all right? But how many disciples did Jesus have? Okay, mm-hmm. Somebody type that in. Or at class, pause it for a second and ask your class, how many disciples did Jesus have? How many disciples? And it wasn't one.
More than two. Six.
In fact, it was more than six.
Yep.
All right, well, let's see. Let's count these. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 disciples, exactly. 12 disciples, that's how many he had. I heard that you can actually do all the disciples' names. And I got to be honest, I normally cannot do them from memory. So how do you do that?
Well, I learned this just today. It's pretty fun. I don't know. I can write it up for the teachers later if you want. It says Peter's jars of jelly and peanut butter make the juiciest, tastiest sandwiches. So let's go through the disciples. Let's see.
I don't see how that helps outside of Peter.
I know.
You can't know the disciples just from that.
You look
Peter's jars of jelly and...
Yes.
And peanut butter make the juiciest
and tastiest sandwiches. Mm.
There is no disciple named Sandwich. Sorry, didn't work.
Well, we're
all
gonna
right. Sorry we wasted your time.
No. We're going to take the first letter of each of the words.
Okay.
Are you ready?
All right. Well, if you think you know it, you tell me.
I'm going to try and do this, okay? So, of course, we have Peter, and then J is John, and then the other J is James. And A is Andrew, and P is Philip, and B is Bartholomew, and M is Matthew, and T is Thomas, Juicius, another James, because we had two James.
Yeah, there are two James, mm-hmm. You're right.
Another T for Thaddeus, and an S for Simon.
Simon the Zealot, right.
Yes, and then, just so you know, I actually have 13 here because I don't know if you remember this or not, but Judas betrayed Jesus. And so they got another disciple, and that's our for Matthias.
Yeah.
Isn't that cool?
I'm impressed.
All right.
So... That would be weird if we had a disciple named Juiciest.
I know. That would be weird.
Yeah. But or James makes more sense.
Mm-hmm.
Or
yeah.
All right.
All right.
All right. So now we have. All right. Let's just review. We have fish, Jesus plus 12 disciples. We have a boat.
Mm-hmm.
All right. We have boat. We also have the SSJPS. Okay. Floating through.
Mm-hmm.
But here's the story. And this is one of the stories from the Gospels, okay? If you'll remember, how many Gospels are there? Four. You're right. Can you name them? Can you name them?
I know that the third graders can.
You know the third graders can?
I know they can do it.
All right. So, Matthew,
Mark, Luke, and John. You're right. And this is the story of how one of the disciples were called to follow Jesus. You see, at least four of the disciples, at least four of them, this would be like big time bonus if you can know which four for sure were fishermen. At least four were. There's a couple more that could have been, we don't know. But they, at least four definitely were. Do you know which they are? That's a hard question. I will tell you, that's probably one of those teacher questions or a parent question or a grandparent question. But it's James and John and Peter and his brother Andrew. All right? James and John, Peter and Andrew. But Peter, one time Jesus was coming. That's the big fish, right? That's the big fish. He's coming along and he comes and he says, he's got so many people that want to hear him talk. And he doesn't have a sound system. There were no sound systems in that day. But what he could do is if he got in a boat, he could go out on the water and the water would help carry his voice. And so all the people gathered on the seashore and Peter got in a boat and pushed out into the water. And Jesus is teaching and all of these things. And at one point, Peter says to Jesus, and let's just say, okay, I'm going to have Mrs. Shanks hold. We're going to say this guy's Peter. There's Peter. He falls on his knees and he says, Jesus, you got to go away from me. I'm a sinful man. And Jesus said, Peter, Peter, I want you to come and follow me. And he says these strange words. And he says, I will make you, do you know, a fisher, not a fish, not of all these fish, a fisher of men, a fisher of men. And that was Jesus' call to Peter. He said, come and follow me. And you know what? They took that boat back to the shore, and Peter did just that. And his brother Andrew followed, and James and John, those four fishermen, all followed Jesus right away. And as they followed Jesus, that was just, you know, and so I want you to understand when Jesus says, now follow me, and I'm going to make you a fisher of men, he's not meaning you're going to try to hook and drag people around. What he is going to say is, everybody wants to have life, and I'm sending you out to offer love and life to all people. That's what it means to follow Jesus. Not only do we get to experience the life and the love and the forgiveness of Jesus, because this same Jesus was going to eventually, he was going to give his life on a cross. And he was going to take his life back on the third day and the resurrection and Easter. And he's going to say, I want you, Peter. And even after the resurrection, he got Peter and Peter said, man, I really blew it because I denied you three times. And Jesus said, Peter, come follow me. Come follow me. He doesn't say about the fisher of men again, but he reminded him, Peter, I called you. You're my disciple. Now come and follow me. And you go out. And I want to just say one more thing. This is a bonus.
Yes.
This is a bonus.
This is pretty cool.
This is a little bonus knowledge that in the early church, in the early days of the church, when the Romans, they didn't like the Christians, the Jewish people at that point didn't like the Christians always. And there were people who would persecute. That means they didn't want the Christians to keep talking about Jesus. And so the Christians would meet in secret and they would use a symbol on their door or on somewhere where people could see. And it was the symbol of the fish, the fish. And the Greek word and that Greek world that they were living in, the Greek word for fish is ichthus. That's how it's said, ichthus.
I think they should all try it at home, say that word.
Yeah, say it, or in your classroom.
Yeah.
Say it, repeat after me. Ichthus.
Ichthus.
Ichthus. It's, ichthus. And you know what it means? It stood for, ichthus stood for the initials, just like we did the initials with the juiciest and tastiest. What they used and did was they said, that was the Jesus. Jesus, the Chi, was the Christ, then the Son of God, Savior. So it stood for, ichthus meant Say this after me. Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
Son of God.
Son of God.
Savior.
Savior.
Ichthus.
Ichthus.
There it is.
Cool.
So isn't that cool?
Yes.
Isn't that cool?
I love
All
it.
Right. All right.
We're going to sing a song now.
You want to sing a song?
All we right. are. We're going to sing the Fisher of Men song.
Okay.
So it's very repetitive.
All right.
And pretty easy to sing, I think.
Okay.
All right. We ready?
We'll see if I do it right or not.
I will make you fishers of men, fishers of men, fishers of men. I will make you fishers of men if you follow me. If you follow me, if you follow me. I will make you fishers of men if you follow me.
All right, gonna do it again. It's I will make you fishers of men, fishers of men, fishers of men. I will make you fishers of men if you follow me. And then the chorus is, if you follow me, if you follow me, I will make you fishers of men if you follow me.
Try one more time. I will make you fishers of men.
All right, so do we have any special things?
I can't really think of anything.
I am going to tell you, kids, we got some cool things coming up in Advent. We're not that far away, and you're going to hear more as we get closer. But maybe you better close us out in prayer, and let's thank God for sweet treats like fishers of men, right? Being fishers of men.
All right, so let's fold our hands, bow our heads, close our eyes, and we're going to do an echo prayer. So here we go. Dear Jesus.
Dear Jesus.
We thank you.
We thank you.
For sweet treats.
For sweet treats.
Such as.
Such as.
Fishers of men.
Fishers of men.
Help us.
Help us.
To be just like the disciples.
To be just like the disciples.
Where we go out.
Where we go out.
And tell others.
And tell others.
All about your love.
All about your love.
Because.
Because.
We.
We.
Follow.
Follow.
You.
You.
Amen.
Amen.
All right.
All right. We will see you next week. We've got two more Cooking with Jesus episodes, and then we got some special things happening after that.
That'd be so exciting. So we're going to say bye from Lessons from 48th Lane. Good night, everybody.